Hello, everybody. I'm very happy to be here. I hope you can hear me well. Anyway, I will not say many words because we brought you a small documentary movie we have produced to show the objectives, the implementation, and the impacts of our pilot project in Bolivia. So, yeah, I hope you enjoy the movie. And afterwards, I will be happy to answer your questions.
First, there is a solar home system with a 50-watt peak. This system is normally used to provide a family that does not have access to the electrical grid with basic electricity services, such as light, radio, television, and cell phone chargers. There are currently nearly 30,000 of these systems installed in Bolivia. Second, there is a solar dryer that is used in rural areas for drying meat, tea, fruits, and other foods. Some of these products are exported to developed countries through fair trade. Third, there's an example of an efficient cooking stove, widespread in rural areas of the country, to limit the consumption of firewood and deforestation. A photovoltaic water pumping system is incorporated in the greenhouses for vegetable production on the farm. In order to supply the cheese production with hot water, a 200-liter solar thermal system was installed. These systems can also be used for healthcare outposts or community showers. In the area of organic product sales, a 110-watt peak photovoltaic system for cooling was installed. A 400-watt, 10-meter-high wind turbine provides light to the stables for cows and pigs. Finally, there are two biodigesters that produce biogas using the waste from the stables. In addition to the power generation systems, there are measurement systems, such as a 20-meter-high anemometer and radiometer. One of the first activities undertaken at the demonstrative center was a training workshop for community members from Batallas and nearby communities. The trainer explained the operation, use, maintenance, and price of renewable energy systems, which were not known at the time as an alternative for energy production.
Muchas veces se puede ver aquí en las comunidades que vengan desde la ciudad. Esperar aquí es un poco costoso, digamos, comprar también cada vez, una vez al mes, estarlo comprando, haciendo filas. Tener esos biodigestores en cada familia, digamos, en cada domicilio sería bueno.
Esto del biodigestor es mucho mejor para la comunidad. Hay momentos, por ejemplo, en tiempo de lluvia no tenemos bosques en el campo, no hay bosques para cocinarnos y esto salvaría bastante.
Estamos muy, muy interesados en que nuestras acciones realmente lleguen a los sectores, aquellos que más lo necesitan. Sectores poblacionales que normalmente no tienen acceso a formación superior en las ciudades. Entonces constituye un elemento fundamental que pone de relieve la responsabilidad de la universidad frente a su pueblo, frente a su sociedad.
To train professors from different universities in La Paz in the inclusion of renewable energies in their curricula and the use of the demonstrative center as a teaching and research laboratory, a seminar was held at the facilities of the Rural Academic Unit in Batallas.
Espero pronto y mostrar todo el conjunto de instrumentos de energías renovables para que justamente en la carrera de arquitectura puedan tener más conocimiento y aplicar en lo que es vivienda rural, vivienda periférica o periurbana y aún vivienda urbana.
Not long after, the demonstrative center received its first visit from a class of mechatronics engineering students with their professor, who explained the operation of each of the systems.
Permite a los estudiantes tener una experiencia práctica, una experiencia en la que ellos pueden tocar, pueden ver en qué consiste y además ver los beneficios que da en el campo.
un medio al alcance de investigadores que pueden, digamos, profundizar con este centro demostrativo proyectos específicos para estudiar, por ejemplo, el impacto que puede tener las energías limpias sobre el desarrollo local.
Cumple básicamente tres funciones, ¿no? La función de generar conocimiento, por un lado, por el otro, difundir ese conocimiento, y por el otro, enlazar ese conocimiento con las necesidades del entorno socioeconómico.
Some students will conduct research on the operation of the systems and their acceptance by the industrial farm workers. The introduction of a degree specializing in energy is also underway.
Está planteando serias transformaciones en los diseños curriculares, en los contenidos. No solamente estamos planteándonos ahora que debería ser una sola materia, sino todas las asignaturas deberían valorar el efecto medioambiental, la utilización de la energía y el desarrollo de ese tipo de energía.
The official opening of the Demonstrative Center for Renewable Energy Technologies was attended by the key players of the energy sector in Bolivia. Representatives from government ministries, international cooperation agencies, companies, NGOs, universities, research institutes, community organizations and other entities were present. To also specifically promote the use of the demonstrative center by sector professionals, the GELARE project included two training sessions for municipal technicians regarding the use, operation, and maintenance of photovoltaic systems. In this way, the center was able to cover the very diverse needs for education, training, and research in the area of renewable energy, addressing such diverse participants as rural residents, municipal technicians, students, and university professors.
Con este proyecto, yo creo que es sumamente importante, no solamente para la Universidad Católica Boliviana, repito, sino también para el área rural y para lo que es la formación en el campo, y precisamente un tema tan trascendental como son las energías.
In the future of the Demonstrative Center for Renewable Energy Technologies, it is sought to promote the training of professionals and technicians specializing in renewable energy, as well as applied research in this area, improve the operation, acceptance, and dissemination of renewable energies in rural areas, and thereby contribute to sustainable development in Bolivia.
Wenn Sie gleich noch Fragen beantworten, dann behalten Sie das Mikro ruhig. Dann machen Sie
okay.
Okay, so if you have any questions, I'm open to answer them.
How many people in the community have been visiting the center until now?
Well, from the rural communities outside Batallas, it were about 30 community members.
Okay.
Students, I think until now, 350 students from different courses and different universities have gone there. Also about 20 or 30 university professors which have received capacity building. And I think 20 or 25 technicians from different municipalities who also received capacity building. Yeah. Anybody else? Yeah. Yeah, they were especially interested in the biogas digesters because, well, they all have cattle,
yes,
so they can use it very well. And also, well, as they told in the movie, they have some problems to receive gas for cooking, so they could use very well the biodigesters. And also in the solar thermal system, they were especially interested for hot water production. And, well, they also have interest in the photovoltaic systems, but they are also very expensive for them to access to. Yeah. Okay. There are no more questions then. Thank you very much.